A significant percentage of civil litigation claims are resolved by motions for summary judgment. How do these motions work? The Massachusetts Supreme Judicial Court considered this question in Slaven v. City of Salem. Salem police arrested Joseph Fitzgibbons for gross lewdness. At the police station, the arresting officer ordered Joseph to empty his pockets, then placed him alone in a holding cell. Joseph wore his shirt untucked, apparently concealing the fact that he was wearing a belt. Joseph's sister Mary Slaven and her husband visited Joseph in the jail a few hours after his arrest. About an hour after Slaven's visit, another officer discovered Joseph hanging by his belt from a bar in the cell door. Efforts to revive him failed. Slaven, as administrator of Joseph's estate, sued the city of Salem, alleging that the officer's negligence resulted in Joseph's suicide. Slaven's complaint claimed that the officers knew or should have known that Joseph was at risk of suicide. The city filed a motion for summary judgment, arguing that Slaven couldn't prove that the officers were negligent. In support of its motion, the city offered sworn affidavits in which two officers testified that they didn't know or have any reason to know that Joseph was suicidal. The officers also stated that they didn't know that Joseph was wearing a belt. Slaven's response to the city's motion included no affidavits or other evidence. The trial court granted the city's motion for summary judgment. Slaven appealed to the Court of Appeals, but the Supreme Judicial Court took the case on its own motion.